it's the Mar-a-Lago raid or the Unselect Committee hoax, the perfect Georgia phone call, it was absolutely perfect, or the Stormy Horseface Daniels extortion plot, they're all sick and it's fake news.
You know, it is admittedly difficult sometimes to remember all of the legal challenges and investigations facing Donald Trump. So I'd like to thank him for reminding us on a regular basis of how many crimes he's alleged to have committed. Great strategy, bud. Anyway, I was hoping that today on the show, we'd be able to give you some sort of live update about the Stormy Daniels. I'm just gonna say her actual name without needlessly throwing in physical insults against the woman that you clearly wanted to have an affair with and might have actually done it. But we do have updates on another case. Remember, he is still being investigated by a special counsel when it comes to the document scandal, the stolen classified documents. And we have an update on that with US Judge Beryl Howell writing last week that prosecutors in special counsel Jack Smith's office have decided that at least at like a base level, they have proven that there appears to have been criminal violations. And I wanna make sure that you know about this, but I also wanna make clear that you don't get ahead of yourselves. We always wanna make sure that you pump the brakes. To point out that they have laid out evidence that indicates the possible existence of some sort of criminal violation is very important, particularly when it comes to the continuation of his attorney-client privilege with some of his lawyers who are currently engaged in the case. But that does not necessarily mean that thus now let's just wrap this thing up. To actually get him on these crimes, you would probably have to present more evidence. And the judge makes clear that in the ruling right there. But does say that prosecutors showed sufficient evidence that Trump intentionally concealed the existence of additional classified documents from lawyer Corcoran, this is Evan Corcoran, putting Corcoran in an unwitting position to deceive the government. That is potentially important, probably for the legal future of Evan Corcoran as well, if it can be pointed out that it wasn't an intentional act in deceiving the government. But Howell goes on to say that Evan Corcoran should comply with the grand jury subpoena for testimony on six separate lines of inquiry over which he had previously asserted attorney-client privilege. Sources added that Howell also ordered Corcoran to hand over a number of records tied to what Howell described as Trump's alleged criminal scheme, echoing prosecutors. Pretty awesome to have the judge using that term. Those records include handwritten notes, invoices, and transcriptions of personal audio recordings. We're gonna have Trump's response to this, but this is potentially important. And I understand that for many of you who've been following this case from the very beginning, your response is probably, yeah, well, duh, because we know that he's been lying about all of this. It doesn't feel like it should matter over much whether he was also lying to his lawyers, but everyone who is not a regular person in this case is deeply concerned about motivation and what was known and when and all of that stuff. And in that realm, this development could be very important. JR, what do you think? I believe that you have muted yourself.
Someone.
Nobody puts JR on the corner.
No one. This is one of those situations where you see Donald Trump continuing to do these types of things right in broad daylight. And as you said, many people already knew it. But is this just the piling on of more and more and more things? And to the point where no matter what they come and get him on, which, you know, as you were pointing out, you were looking for the potential indictment, maybe even arrest based off of the payment plan with Stormy Daniels, which was obviously a problem there. But then also then to the covering up of the documents. There's so many things keep piling up. You're trying to figure out, so at what point are we gonna start taking any of this seriously? Because one of the ones that they do take seriously, then when they finally get him on something, if it's gonna be like, how dare they keep coming for him? Which is why he keeps repeating all of his crimes, to downplay all of them. If you hear about them a million times, it turns into just normalcy. It's a normal approach for a former president to go through and do all of these things. And by the way, even from just the payment and things like that, they're gonna complain that this stuff is coming out, right? Or that you're coming for this president. Yo, the problem that they have with this entire Twitter file stuff that Elon Musk was pushing, and the weaponization of the government, and the coordination of the government with Twitter, and all the stuff that they're trying to push, they wanted to see the president, current president's son's penis, because it was on some computer somewhere. Because they said that would have changed the outcome of the election. I want you to think about that. They said they want to see this guy's privates because it would have allowed Donald Trump to potentially win the 2020 election, which, by the way, they said he won anyway. So that doesn't make any sense. But what they're trying to cover up now is that he paid off this woman he had an affair with. because he was not looking to not be embarrassed to make sure he won the election. Isn't that about the same thing? You're trying to cover up embarrassing things so that you won't be judged by voters, right? That's what you're saying the Bidens were doing in Twitter, including with them. If you do the exact same thing, how is it not a problem? And in fact, you went further to pay someone off to make sure that it doesn't become public with, of course, funds that you're trying to hide and cover up and then sent through your guy. I know we weren't talking about the Stormy Daniels stuff, but the thing is I want to point out again just how hypocritical these entire process and approaches that they have when it comes to how they're arguing how innocent Donald Trump is and all these things. And now the classified documents case. If they come from on it, they're going to say, look, they're trying to get him on anything.
Oh, they will. I mean, we just have to resign ourselves to that. I mean, they've been saying that from the very beginning. They will. When you pointed that out, it reminded me of this quote from Andor. And that is the real trick of the imperial thought machine. It's easier to hide behind 40 atrocities than a single incident.
Yeah,
you overwhelm people with your illegal acts. That's clearly a strategy. I think he also likes doing them, so that makes it an easy strategy to follow. But yeah, at the end of the day, we are never going to get them to accept reality. A lot of them, you know, 50 million, 70 million, I don't know, a lot of people. What matters is reality and what matters is results. So hoping that at the end of the day, everyone is gonna take their blindfold off and a rainbow is gonna be over all of us and we're all gonna accept reality is just not how this thing is gonna play out, unfortunately. In any event, very briefly before we move on to other news, they did respond, Trump campaign spokesperson, to ABC News revealing what the judge had said, saying, shame on fake news ABC for broadcasting illegally leaked false allegations from a never Trump, now former chief judge against the Trump legal team. The real story here that fake news ABC should be reporting on is that prosecutors only attack lawyers when they have no case whatsoever. So it's legally leaked and fake. I feel like you're allowed to leak fake stuff after all. I mean, that's not actually revealing it. The whole thing is nonsense. It doesn't mean anything. We're gonna see what happens.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.